Assalamu alaikum. My name is Alish Banas, and from here I will continue my part, which is diseases related to maltose and lactose. So from the next slide, we will start with maltose. Since we know that maltose is made up of two molecules of glucose and does not contain any fructose molecule, it can be a little bit healthier than the normal table sugar. But we should know that maltose is also a sugar, so if it is not taken in a moderate amount, it can cause several diseases. When we use maltose in a moderate amount, our body uses it for energy. But if excess of maltose is consumed, it may harm our body. So the diseases that are related to maltose are maltose intolerance. Maltose intolerance is a type of disorder caused by reduced or absent activity of maltose enzymes needed for the breakdown of this disaccharide, which is rare in humans. Moving to the causes, it may be also caused due to the inflammatory damage to the cells of small intestine. This damage is caused when a parasite or microorganism like virus or bacteria cause infection and damage the cell lining of the intestine. Use of strong drugs and medications taken by mouse, such as antibiotics, may cause damage to the intestinal cells, resulting in maltose intolerance. It can also be hereditary. Inheritance is by an autosomal recessive pattern, which means both parents must have the mutation for the child to develop the disease. Symptoms. Symptoms that commonly result due to the maltose intolerance are abdominal bloating, abdominal pain, fluctuations, watery diarrhea or loose stool, occasional nausea and vomiting. These digestive problems can lead to lower than normal weight gain and growth. Upper respiratory tract, air and viral infections are common, and kidney stones and copper malabsorption may be more frequent. Diagnosis. An intolerance is diagnosed based on the symptoms following the test and the gas concentration in the breath samples. So from the next slide, we will discuss preventions. Preventions. Reduction and sometimes strict avoidance of maltose intake is required. This means avoiding table sugar in all forms, such as sugar cane, sugar beet, powdered sugar, rock candy, brown sugar, etc. In many affected individuals, sources of starch needed to be avoided as well. Now, the second disease is obesity. Consuming a diet high in added sugar can lead to obesity. Causes and effects. It is because they contain large amount of calories and they are not taken in moderate amount, it will surely affect our body. It also have an impact on our hormones level, which can lead to the gaining of weight. One of the reasons for obesity is that these sugars like maltose displaces the healthy food. Symptoms. The most obvious symptom is the increase in weight. Therefore, the symptoms that may be present arise from this increase in weight. They may be difficulty in sleeping, back and joint pains, excessive sweating, intolerance to heat, infections, fatigue, depression, feeling of shortness of breath. Diagnosis. Obesity is diagnosed when our body mass index BMI is 30 or higher. Preventions. Exercise regularly, follow a healthy diet plan, monitor your weight regularly, be consistent. So moving on to the next slide. Diabetes. Glucose and maltose increases the blood glucose level most rapidly of all the sugars and therefore increase the insulin secretions. Its causes. Immune system, which normally fights harmful bacteria or viruses, attacks and destroys your insulin producing cells in the pancreas. This leaves you with little or no insulin. It can be hereditary. It can be used during pregnancy when sugar or glucose enters the bloodstream. Symptoms. Increased thirst, frequent urination, extreme hunger, unexplained weight loss, fatigue, irritability, blood vision, slow healing sores, frequent infections such as gums or skin infections and vaginal infections. How can we prevent it? Cut sugar and refined carbohydrates from your diet. Work out regularly, drink water, lose weight if you are overweight, follow a very low carb diet. Since we know that increased amount of maltose is not healthy for our body, so increased intake of high amount of maltose can lead to heart diseases and kidney diseases as well. So now we are coming to our next part, which is lactose. Lactose is also a disaccharide. It is basically present in milk. Our body uses an enzyme called lactase to break down that sugar so we can absorb it in our bodies. But if our body fails to break it down, it can lead to different diseases. There are not so many diseases that can be caused due to lactose, but the major one is lactose intolerance. So lactose intolerance is a condition in which person fails to digest a sugar in milk and milk products called lactose. People with lactose intolerance don't have enough lactase, which is produced in small intestine. So moving on to our next slide, we will discuss causes, symptoms and diagnosis and preventions of lactose intolerance. Causes of lactose intolerance. Primary lactase deficiency is the most common cause of lactose intolerance worldwide. This type of lactase deficiency is caused by an inherited genetic fault that runs in families. Secondary lactase deficiency is another cause of lactose intolerance, particularly in babies and young children, which can be affected due to the infections in stomach and intestine, adverse effects of both conditions that affect the large intestine, long courses of antibiotics. Congenital lactase deficiency is a rare condition that runs in families and is found in newborn babies. In this, affected babies produce no or very little lactase. Symptoms. Symptoms of lactose intolerance usually develop within a few hours of consuming food or drink that contains lactose. They may include diarrhea, farting, a bloated stomach, stomach cramps and pains, stomach rumbling, feeling sick. Diagnosis. A doctor might suspect lactose intolerance based on your symptoms and your response to reducing the amount of dairy products in your diet. He confirms the diagnosis by conducting one or more tests, which are hydrogen bread test or lactose intolerance test. How can we prevent it? To lower the amount of lactose in our diet, limit milk and other dairy products, include small servings of dairy products in your regular meals, eat and drink lactose-reduced ice cream and milk, add a liquid or powder lactase enzyme to milk to break down the lactose. As the both sugars are a part of our daily diet, we should keep a check and balance on their intake and avoid taking more than moderate amount of these sugars to prevent these diseases. This was all for the diseases of maltose and lactose. Thank you.